Welcome, Jennifer Love Hewitt! Women like a guy in a t-shirt and his hat on backwards. That's good.
Thank you. Hello.
Hey, you finally got your driver's license, huh?
I did.
Have you got your license? Let me see.
Yeah, I have it somewhere. Where is it? It is.
Okay, there
right
it is. There.
Here.
Let me see. Wow, because you were working on this the last.
Yeah, time. I was.
God, you were like.
I worked for 2 hours. I got up 2.5 hours early before my test to do my hair and makeup.
Well, you know they never do justice on
me. So that it would look normal.
Yeah.
And nice.
Well, let's show people.
All right.
We blocked out your obviously
you
your dress. Okay, Ellen, can you go close on? Oh, look at that. You really look older.
No, show him the real one.
No, all right, show him the real one.
Show him the real one.
There's the real way.
You go. Yay!
Put that right there.
All right.
Well, that's pretty good.
Thank you.
Now, how did your test go? Did you do well?
Well, I was really nervous. I was really, really nervous because, of course, I've been afraid to drive for a really long time. and I got in there, and the woman at the DMV was very serious. It was, like, straight out of the Brady Bunch. I was like, okay, and she told me to start the car, and I couldn't, like, I blanked and couldn't figure out how to start the car. I was like, this is going well so far. And then I finally got the car started, and we drove, and I was trying not to, like, be myself as much as possible, which is like laughing and giggling and saying sarcastic things and listening to Kiss FM and all of that stuff. So I was being really normal, and she was like, yeah, now turn here and blah, 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 blah. And I was like, okay. And we got back, and as we pulled in, I was like, so? And she goes, before I tell you whether you got your license or not, what's going to happen with Bailey and Sarah on Wednesday?
Ooh.
And I went, what? I was like, you just put me through all of that, and you wanted to know what happens with Bailey and Sarah? And she's like, well, are you going to tell me? And I was like, well, did I get my license? And she's like, yeah. And I was like, okay.
That's
and so we sent the car for like 10 minutes, and
that's
I told
great
him the story.
There you go. You haven't had any accidents, have you?
No, not so far.
Not even bumped a car parking?
Knock on wood.
No, didn't even bump a car parking or anything?
I've bumped an occasional car. Parking, but that's all right. That's normal.
Well, you know what I find fascinating?
That's what bumpers are for.
That's what bumpers are for.
Had to test it out, make sure it works.
It's a good attitude to have.
There you go.
Now, you know, every time I talk to you, oh, you hate scary movies. You're fine. This is the second scary movie in a row you've done.
Right.
But do you like them? You don't even like scary movies.
I hate scary movies.
Yeah.
I think they're the worst things. But it's a way for me to sort of face my biggest fear, which is being afraid. So I kind of like throw myself into it, literally.
So this is therapy more
it's
than...
It's therapy for me, yes. And I, you know, I had never seen a horror movie before we did the first I Know What You Did.
Oh, come on.
I had never seen one. I was like, absolutely not am I watching those things. They're way too scary, which is the whole point, obviously.
Right.
But so Freddie and Ryan, Freddie Prinze Jr. and Ryan Felipe from the first movie, sat me down and they were like, okay, you have to watch scary movies. And so I watched Psycho, and I watched The Shining, and I watched In the Mouth of Madness, and I was terrified, and still don't watch scary movies.
Well, let me explain something. Now, in both these movies, now in this movie, you're soaking wet through the whole movie. I don't quite understand. I don't quite understand why. I mean, do you do
it's
your hair before you go in, and then
right
they, and then you just soak.
Yeah, no, as unattractive as it actually looks, which you guys have obviously not seen the movie yet, or else you would not be screaming. But it's we smelled like a football team at the end of the day.
Well, that's what I was thinking. Now you see,
I smelled like an entire football team by myself. It was like it was 110 degrees outside in Mexico, and we had rain machines, so I was wet for literally like 18 hours a day, and so it was like mildew. It was just disgusting. It was absolutely the nastiest thing in the world, and it's supposed to look attractive.
Every clip, you're saying, I'm like your dad. I've been watching you since you've been a little kid here, so I'm very protective of these kind of sleazeball guys. So when I see you all soaking around, I go, hey, I was afraid you'd catch a cold. I mean, I got
really sick while we were filming. Everybody sort of got sick. It was really tough.
And it's recycled water, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Like, so it's like... if you sneezed in this water 10 minutes ago, you're going to sneeze in it again.
You're going to sneeze in it again later.
Were there a lot of bugs? And
we had the worst. We worked in mango orchards in Mexico, like the last 3 days that we were there. And there were these bugs that I've never. First of all, we had scorpions falling on us from trees, which is no fun because you're walking back from lunch with, like, your burrito, and all of a sudden you feel this thing crawling on you, and you look over, and it's like, hi, I'm your friend Scorpion. How's it going? And it's, like, laying on your shoulder, which is absolutely disgusting. But then we had beetles that were mating. Okay, so there weren't just like 10 of them, there were 400 in the space that we were filming. It was a huge gathering.
It's like an orgy.
They came to watch us film, and they would pee acid-like stuff on your skin.
They would pee acid?
Yeah.
What movie went now?
They'd have to use the bathroom. they would like crawl up your pants and your shirt and at any...
Like being on a date with those guys. You know, they also pee acid, by the way.
But like at any given time, literally, your fellow actor would just reach up and slap you as hard as they could across the head. I had one on my tongue. That was the most disgusting part ever. I was in the middle of a scream, and it just landed there. Luckily, I didn't know it happened. It flew out like just as I was getting ready to shut my mouth. Anyway.
Now, we have a clip here. What's this clip? Is this a soaking wet clip?
But of course.
Okay. This. Okay, you know, if you button your shirt, you won't catch cold.
Yeah.
All right, here's this. Now, what's happening here? This is it. Obviously, is this in a graveyard?
This is the mango orchards, which is the graveyard.
It's a graveyard.
And Julie, at this point, is a little peeved at the situation and is about to tell people how it's going to be.
Let's take a look. I still know what you did.
What's today's date? July 4th. I'm not gonna die on this island! Do you hear me? If you want me bad, come and get me! I'm right here! But my grave stays empty! Julie, this is crazy, all right? The phone lines are down and the boats are gone and there's no way off this island.
Yes, then we fight.
I'm protecting you from these sleazy guys. And you also sing the soundtrack, right?
I do. I have the title single off the soundtrack. Yes, it's called How Do I Deal?
Yeah. How was that? Oh, that was fun.
It was great.
Yeah,
it was really, really fun. It's
well,
a
that's
good.
Song. You know, before we go to commercial, we'll play a little of your singing
Thank
on the soundtrack.
Thank you so much.
I'm so proud of you.
Thank
I'm so glad you've
Thank
become
you
a huge
so
star. It's wonderful. Congratulations. Here's your soundtrack. Be right back with.